As we are aware that since 27th November 2020, a large number of farmers are protesting at three borders of Delhi, and from time to time they had engaged in various activities. In this context, during the tractor rally held on 26 January 21, large-scale violence was witnessed at the various places in Delhi, and the same was handled by Delhi police with utmost restraint. And after 26 January incident, a large number of instances of fake news, manipulated or edited videos instigating disaffection and misleading propaganda posts were spreading on the social media. On 4th of February, while monitoring the social media, we came across a Google document titled Toolkit on Twitter. Initial investigation of this toolkit document revealed that it was created by a pro-Khalistani group named Poetic Justice Foundation and people associated with it. One portion of the toolkit document mentioned action points named prior action. As you are aware, they were digital strike through, hashtag on 26 January, and earlier, tweet storm on 23rd January onwards, and physical action on 26th January, and entering Delhi for Kisan Rally and return back to the border. The second part of the same document mentions tasks such as disruption of India's cultural heritage such as yoga and tea, and targeting Indian embassies abroad in various capitals. The time-bound action points and program given in the toolkit, when viewed in the context of actual developments in Delhi, clearly showed that the action plan that was formulated in the toolkit was implemented on ground or executed in a copycat manner. Keeping in mind all these facts, a case was registered, wide FIR number 49 by 2021, and the investigation was taken up by CIPED, Cyber Unit of Delhi Police. During the investigation, many screenshots of the toolkit document available on open source were investigated. As soon the investigation was able to fetch enough information, a search warrant was obtained from the Honorable Court on 9th February 21 against one Nikita Jacob, one of the editors of the toolkit Google document. A team headed by the IO of the case reached Mumbai and conducted searches at her house on 11th February 21. After due intimation to the Mumbai police, and two laptops and one iPhone was found, and during the search, several incriminating information was retrieved. Keeping in mind that the person whose premises is being searched is a woman, and as per the court order, the search was carried out in the daytime, and the investigating team wound up the day search and requested Ms. Nikita to make herself available at her house on the next morning. She gave a written undertaking to remain present at her house. The initial examination of Nikita revealed that she and her associate Shantanu and Disha had created the toolkit Google document. The email account created by Shantanu is the owner of this document, and all others are its editor. A woman named Puneet, who is based in Canada, connected these people to the pro-Khalistani Poetic Justice Foundation, and through them created the toolkit Google document titled Global Farmer Strike and Global Day of Action 26th January. On 11th January, Nikita and Shantanu, Nikita and Shantanu attended a Zoom meeting organized by Poetic Justice Foundation, in which the modalities of the Global Day of Action were worked out. Based on the course of action decided in the Zoom meeting, Nikita, Shantanu, Disha, and others collaborated towards the draft of the toolkit. Based on the information gathered from Nikita and her device, separate teams were sent to Maharashtra, Bid district, and Bangalore. In bed, Shantanu was not found at his house, and we are still searching for him. On the next morning, when the investigation team reached Nikita's residence, it was learned that she has absconded and still not joined the investigation. As such, for Nikita and Shantanu, we have taken NVWs from the Honorable Court. In Bangalore, the team examined Disha and was able to extract highly incriminating information from her phone. This information made it clear that Disha, along with her colleagues Shantanu and Nikita, created and sent a toolkit document to others. Disha, who is associated with the environmental movement called Fridays for Future, sent the toolkit to Greta Thunberg on Telegram and also coaxed her to act on it. The main aim of the toolkit was to create misinformation and disaffection against the lawfully enacted government. The toolkit sought to artificially amplify the fake news through various tweets which they have created in the form of a tweet bank, and they also sought public to participate in the action on 26 January, that was the Republic Day of India. Based on these incriminating evidences collected against Disha from her device, and in view of the fact that Nikita did not cooperate and she fled from her house, we acted against Disha because she has deleted a WhatsApp group which she created to coordinate among the various members for the toolkit, and her arrest was made in the presence of her mother and in presence of the SHO of the area concerned, and due procedure was adopted for arresting her, for conducting her medical test and producing in the court, and the Honorable Court has granted 5 days PC for Disha. The rest of the investigation is in progress.